Right, so that what we will build inside this tutorial, so that means nothing but it is a good start to explain the grease pencil inside Blender 2.79. It's the basics and it has been greatly improved inside the 2.8 and the 2.81, but we will explain the basics of course. So this simple bounce ball animation has been built using the grease pencil basics. So this is the Blender Daily Tips and Tricks, and you are now watching the lesson number 44. And inside this lesson, we are going to talk about the grease pencil. So let's dive into the tutorial. And now I will start a new file. So this is a brand new file, and let's delete the cube for a moment and replace it with the monkey head. So we can now explain what we will get from the grease pencil. Basically, you will get this grease pencil panel using the N panel, and I think it's must better to activate the screen cast case. Alright, so here using the T tool shelf, you will get this panel grease pencil, and we have some stroke placement here. So the cursor, let's see that we say that we are here, and we draw using the cursor method. You will draw using this cursor, and you will draw like this. And if you draw here using, let's make the cursor here, and if we draw in this square in this area, you will see that we drawing using a projection for the view. But in the view option, we are projecting it to be permanent. So whether you go left or right, you will see that it's stick projected from this old from the old view, and the surface, which is the most useful part, you can draw in the surface. And after drawing, you will see that it's sticking to the surface. So we can draw also here and line. I know some designers that use this option to make ray topology, but this is a matter of choice. And we have the stroke, and personally, I don't know the function for this stroke. Right, so let's delete all the frames. This is the first point inside this tutorial. Secondly, you can play with the colors using the N, and here is a lot of choice and a lot of options you should use. Basically, I will go to this layer, and I will draw an capital K, and you can choose a continuous draw to draw continuously like this. So basically, we have drawn the K, and I will add a new layer. So this is the same layers as in Adobe Photoshop. You can hide layers, and let's draw the A here like this. But both the K and the A is black. How we can change the colors? It's very simple. You can add a new layer here, and this layer will be maybe red, and I will say that the stroke will be red, and we have some fill option. We can leave it as it, or we can decrease or increase the fill. So the stroke and fill, as in Adobe Illustrator, you have the stroke which is here and the fill which is inside. So let's draw an M, and you will see that we have this one, and you can decrease or increase the opacity. If you have an closed boss, you will see that it's filled like this. All right, so let's see what we have. We have the erase, of course. We can erase like this, and if you are using an pen tablet, you will make benefit from the brighter levels. And of course, we have the line, which is drawing a straight line like this. Right, so we have the layers. Let's add another layer, and this layer will be the blue. And inside the same layer, we can add a new layer, which is E, for example. and the E will have a blue color like this. So let's draw the E. Alright, so we can hide the blue one or hide the M, or we can hide the whole logo like this. So we have now hide all these options, and there is some tools which is the tint. So the tint add an extra level of tint like this, and if you increase the tint the factor, you can see that you have a tint like this. And personally, you can animate this one to get most of to get an effect like this. So because you are using the grease pencil, you are making benefit from the vector, and all your files are high quality, all your drawing are high quality, and you can depend on this drawing to make an simple 2D animation. Let's go to the third panel like this, and I will add a new layer, which this layer will be bold. So basically, this is the third option inside our tutorial. And now I will make for the timeline some space, because we will use it. So let's here is the timeline, and we will stick for 70 frames, and let's start from the frame number one, and we are here in the front view, and the cursor in the center, and let's draw our ball. So I will say that we have an layer. This layer will called the ball, and we have some colors, and the first color will be, let's add a tint. For example, if you want to add the colors, I think it's a matter of choice. So we have the tint, and the factor will be like this. Alright, and this is the first frame. Then I will go to the frame number 10 and draw something here. And in the 20, we can draw a frame here. And in the 30, we can draw a frame here. And of course, in the 40, we can draw a frame here. And in the 50, we can draw a frame here. And in the 60, we can draw a frame here. And in the 70, we can draw a frame here. So let's play that. You will see that you have this ball bouncing like this. It's not in decreasing in the size, but this is imaginary. So how we can make the animation? So I will now. Then I have activated the onion skinning, and the onion skinning, as you see here, it's drawing an it's drawing the framing before and after. So we will make before 10 and after maybe 15, and let's play back. Alright, and after that I will go to the edit stroke, and we can go to the interpolate, and between every frame you can click sequence to make some frames like this. And if you want to interpolate here, you can click interpolate and make some frame like this, and it's sequence, and you can go between the basic or the key poses and click sequence. And I think now we are done for our animation. Let's play back. As you can see, we are now. So what about the colors? We haven't added any colors yet, so we can draw a color like this. And let's go here and make the color here. So let's play back our animation. as you can see, this is what we have done so far. But if you want to make an interesting example, you can close your buses. And because I'm drawing only in random shapes, this is the result. And as you can see, the result not perfect, but it's a good start point. So that concludes for this video. And that was the basics for the grease pencil inside Blender. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.